Hi, my name's Dave. But you know that. Another thing you must know is things tend to be a little different here back east. For one thing, we don't have to go to the mountains to get snow. All we have to do is wait, because as the year comes to a close, the snow comes to us. And when this happens, we usually retreat indoors, turn on our televisions, and wait for long periods of time for it to go away. Now this wouldn't be too bad, but we tend to suffer from a side effect called cabin fever. And this is caused from spending long periods of time indoors. And a symptom of this is people tend to become a little goofy and start acting strange. So with this warning, I'm going to introduce the first segment, which is called Christmas 1981. This takes place in a typical middle-class apartment, typical middle-class city with some rather untypical people. So if you have your beer and popcorn ready, we'll go.
I have stage fright. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. And Joni, and because I'm embarrassed and I'm nervous. Because I'm in front of the camera. David, can we cut all this out, David?
No editing.
No, too late now.
Here, we'll okay. Improve the quality right now.
Yes.
Okay. We temporarily
all right. I'm not sure if we're on, if we're on, if we're on. Okay.
Say something silly now.
This is Christmas of 1980, Christmas Eve of 1981. I don't know any good jokes. I'm dull.
What to give the rest of...
Choose
for me, dear.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the,
the best.
Microphone.
Johnny, what's up?
Hands on. Hi, how are you? Yes. This is the event of the, what Christmas is this now? 1981. 1981 to 1982 Christmas. It is, it's snowing outside. The cars are banging up against one another, and we're having one heck of a good time in this year's sauna bath. Ah, yes.
Those are your relatives, not mine. They are blood.
Now, she's pointing at somebody else, but I'm being talking to. Okay, fine, Daddy. Thank you. Thanks for the camera eye again. Now, I shall pass this on to the gentleman with the broken foot. Here, the broken foot is down here.
There, it's
let the man, oh, very good. It's, this is what you call knee-high to a grasshopper. Anyway. There we go. All right. What's your name, young man? Tell the crowd how you broke your foot.
We call it Crip.
What?
She calls me Crip.
Crip.
Yeah. Crip. Crip.
Is it crippled?
How did you grip yourself?
Kathy pushed me down a hill.
I wasn't even trying.
She wanted me to get my hair cut, so she figured best way to do it, push me down a hill, get me knocked out, and then cut it all off by the patrimony.
Should have done the beard at the same time, eh?
No, I was awake for that.
Okay. Wait.
Over to Jen.
Hello.
And here's Johnny.
And here's Johnny. Hello, Carl. Nice to see you here. You're looking great. Wish we were there. I mean, I wish you were here.
Or
we wish we were there, that's right. Okay. I'll hand this over to John.
Remember me, Carl? How you doing? I'm gonna make a quick pass to Matt. 43 Hut. Oh, that's really good. I hope you have a happy Christmas and a good New Year. Whatever else I can say. I don't know what to say. Goodbye. Hi, please send money. Hold on here, cut a second.
Send what?
I know what you're
doing. Hi, welcome once again back here into the kitchen live where we have.
There we go.
Would you like to say a few words to our viewing audience?
Oh, I love it. Oh, Carly, we miss you so much. We wish you were here with us enjoying the holidays. Come back soon. We'd love to have you. Love you.
Hi, here and back, way back here behind the curtain. Take a few words, man.
Hi, Carl.
Hi.
We miss you.
We miss you.
We wish you were here.
We wish you were here.
The Bobbsey twins.
We wish you a Merry Christmas.
And a Happy New Year. Very good.
That's enough.
That's
thank
all.
You. Thank you.
Joni, this is Carl's ex-brother-in-law. He's narrating this wonderful program that you have the privilege of viewing. And if you have any sense at all, you'll change the channel and watch something much more exciting. That's Uncle Johnny shaking his booty over there. As he now unwraps it very carefully to save the paper. And he opens a little tissue package, and there's some Tijuana gold. Sigh. Just what he needed. Just what he needed. It could have been diet pills, and he would have said, just what I needed. 64 silver? Really silver? All right, next one is what, Lynn?
Who's the oldest lady?
All right. All right, ladies, volunteer. Who's the oldest? Now, come on.
Where's the money, John?
Oh, it is. Oh. That's $2 silver.
Aunt Betty.
I'm right there with you, Betty.
Is Aunt Betty the oldest lady? No, but we'll give her the honor of going first anyhow. She doesn't want the blender. Uh-oh. She's going after the booze. Uh-oh. Here she goes. She is going after. Whoa! Yay! Dundee Kate is happy. That's right. Whoa, look at that. Look at her rip it open.
Oh, wonderful.
Uh-oh.
She's gonna. Now you can go take your shower.
She's gonna pamper her body.
I tried to write a poem and it started
we're trying to
like,
tell her
never
something.
Too young and never too old. To pamper our bodies.
But give me the poem.
But Kate, being a lousy poet, thank God she didn't write a poem.
Next man is Raymond. God, I'm glad I'm last.
The old gray-haired jock over in the corner. Come on, Raymond. Hey, get your cheeks over there and grab one. Take one from the right-hand pile. Don't take the one your wife has found.
Not that one.
No, don't take that one, Raymond. No, don't take that one. No.
It's Christmas.
Oh, God, what a production. We're running out of tape.
And Christmas here.
Joni's going to turn on magic. Don't hurry up and pick your choice. Hey, that's women. That's sheer energy. You couldn't stand that.
The snow is thick
what?
In most of the world.
Well, you can't take your own. That's obvious. Now, as we approach New Year's Eve, there you go. Hey!
did Lynn rap that one?
John wanted that.
Aw, oh, John wanted that.
Aww. Well, I'll tell you, some guy must have.
They don't like it.
Oh, did you,
I tried.
Karl, if you're still watching, you're crazier than I thought you were.
And so, my friends, wherever you are.
What is that, a television? It is. I was going to get somebody a Heathkit coffee mug, and I didn't know who in the world would want one.
A Michigan Bell.
Oh. Oh. Oh, wow. A genuine zircon.
Oh,
whoa.
Oh, very good.
Well, the right person got that one. Now you can get out tomorrow and polish your car.
Get busy now.
Kate, you just stepped on your nuts. Kate just stepped on her nuts. I'm the nuts.
I'll make it fast.
Oh, now here comes Grandma. Here she goes. Grandma's crotchety old grandma's going over. Right? Uh-oh, what is that one?
Never know.
Oh, is that the Rubik's cube all taken apart?
Irma, get out of the way. Irma, get out of the way.
Irma!
Irma, wrong.
She got the unassembled Rubik's Cube.
Oh, thank you. I always pick the big square one.
She, she got the lace nighty, but...
Socks.
Socks?
She didn't know what it is.
Oh, a box.
I always wanted one. But you don't know what it is.
Stationery.
Oh, right? Yeah.
Stationery,
look at
and
that.
I've always wanted one.
Sander Stationery.
That's way, you don't like
money.
That's the right way.
Nice.
Oh, I love it. I made the right choice. I really did. Very nice.
How can you love a tin box?
I hope.
Well,
you see, you're writing to
him. Uh-uh.
No.
Paolo.
Matthew.
No. He's got more gray than I do. Which one do I get?
Going next, whatever, which one you want to choose.
Okay.
Sit
on
the floor
this
so
one.
The camera can see you.
I like
mine.
Nice.
I made a good
start.
One.
I gotta do like Raymond. I'll take the watch.
Okay. I have the watch. This is either a Seiko or a Rolex. Which is a Rolex?
Yeah.
Whoa.
Gold.
Look, oh, just
14 karat gold.
Things to do today that I didn't do yesterday. That's what I can use too. Because I note all over the house. I note on toilet paper.
He's a great note maker nowadays.
I just note up the world.
Oh, yes, he goes.
Oh, that's nice.
Except, folks, somebody took the innards out of your pen.
How does it work?
What?
Do your boochie woochie on that one. So let's make that sucker right, and I'll give you a $10 bill.
Oh.
Come on, it's lovely weather for
tell her.
Come on, let's let the next oldest lady get her crickety bone. Pin is
I don't know how to do that.
Good, I can use that. Thank you.
How does it work?
You put the pin inside of it.
Oh!
How does it work?
Okay, Irma.
Oh, good. It's a Parker, too, and I like school.
They're full of paper.
See?
Writing paper.
I got some more money.
Nobody would know.
Well, I would know, and that's lazy.
How come they don't put the guts in?
We put woman.
Oh, well, lady. Everybody in this crowd is a lady.
But we're all calling women.
Oh, great.
Oh,
women are ladies.
Oh,
It'll be the perfect ending.
Start announcing.
Irma has the lace undies. And now she is revealing the secret of the ages, how they fit. There's a happy feeling, nothing in the world. A piece of plastic. Let me see. Let me.
Oh, look, these wonderful things are the things we remember all through our lives. Just hear those sleigh bells jingling, ring-ting-tingling too.
What do they call that stuff when you put it in plastic? Putting it in plastic? Yeah. Carl, whatever they call that, putting it in plastic, it's been put. Come on, it's lovely weather for sleigh ride together with you. It's like a fever thermometer. Almost. Hey, you. Hips. And here she is, with her back, bare back showing through her hole in her blouse. She grabs the biggest one.
I didn't.
Who was the guy? Shouldn't have
some
guy?
Was it a guy? It was a guy.
What?
You chipmunks, ready to sing your song?
Well, who's the guy? Paul. And now Paul Bernardczyk, the little Irish person with the broken foot, will reach and grab his box with a ribbon. Oops. He didn't grab a box. He did grab a box with a ribbon. Yes. Indeed, chocolate-covered cherries. Carefully, he unwraps the package. Whoa, jogging shoes. Pro wings. How about that? Ooh. Oh, ho, ho. He's got a rolling ruler. Now he can measure his foot. Yeah. And now when Kathy says how high is up, he can tell her. And he can also tell her how to get there. Okay. And the young movie star deftly opens her package.
Okay, fellas, get ready. That was very good.
Saving every scrap of paper for posterity. She's trying to figure out how to open it.
Alvin.
Oh, with $100 bill in it. Oh, they used up all. Oh, wow. And another note maker strikes again. She doesn't know. It's too complex for her. Yeah, somebody told you. The world's greatest note makers now have... Look at that. Look at that. She's going to put it in the bottom. You can turn that till hell freezes over and it'll never come off. Look at that. Look at that. Go ahead. Put it in the bottom. Can you believe that?
Let's not overdo it.
Even Kathy knows that you take the top off. Then you unscrew the gut. Then you put its innards in and you put it back together. And now you know why she drives a Jap car, because if it ever broke down, she'd never know what to do with it. And Kathy drives her little hot shot hot rod because she knows how to make them go. Look at, oh yeah, you need a picture of your car from Carl. He's never seen Hot Wheels. Oh, yeah, skinny. No, you get a quill and a little bottle and you dip it in there. Yeah, yeah, and you fill it with an ink bottle. She'll never be able to fill it. She'll call on 12 people in the house to figure out how to fill it. I wonder who had the flu and used up all the Kleenex. That little one happens to be a gold pocket watch that you just flipped off of there. See, I knew I should have put a bow on my box. Somebody would have grabbed it already. Well, whoever gets it is going to be able to use it, and they're all a bunch of dummies for not grabbing it, but that's all right. See, now he thinks he knows what that is. No, it isn't the same thing. Watch him rip his skin open as he tries to open that box. It's factory sealed. Throw this at him. Untouched by human hands. Watch it. Watch as Paul opens his little surprise. Or John, rather, not Paul. Paul's the one with the beard. John doesn't have a beard. Yet. John got a box. John got a box for Christmas. Well, you can use it for a tackle box. You can, whatever you want to keep, you can put in your little box, and it won't spill out. It won't spill out either when you hold it that way. Huh?
Dividers.
See that? He can put 38 cartridges in there. More dividers to make little squares. He can put his gold coin collection in there. And now he's gonna read the instructions. Just like Kate, after it's all together, then he reads the instructions. Then he can trade it with his old man, see, and then he can... Uh-oh. Look at how deftly that package was unwrapped. Oh, a walk.
Hold on, I guess I'll take back the present.
Oh, look at that. Hey, I could use one of those. Kathy, you want a jotter? Oh, look it, you can put the butter in there and warm it so you can dip your lobster in it. Watch her try to hook it on. Look at this. She's another engineer at work. Look at this. Great. Terrific. Hey, terrific. Look at, see that? See that? She got a degree in bowl assembly. No, you've got to start eating salad fixings. Can't make a jello mold in there.
Look at me.
Yeah, there you go. And it's a drip bowl. Yeah, and whatever drips you have the next day.
Soup, coffee. David's next.
Can you believe the waste of a $12 tape?
No. Can you erase it?
No. I certainly hope so.
Wait,
have
your presents.
You can't
take the red one, David.
Why?
You brought that one.
No, he didn't. He didn't bring the red one. I brought the red one. The red one is mine.
Okay,
talk about it. Huh? What can you say about David? He opens the package like an animal. He rips the paper off. Doesn't save the bows. And he opens up the box like he's expecting a $100 bill laying on top. And what in effect he finds? Socks with money! Yay! And believe me, he can use them too. 1980 silver dollars.
Back to work.
And they even...
That's not my box. My box is right here.
David has the box that says Heath Kit. I figured we'd get a commercial in here as long as we were here. Now, Lynn. Oh, Lynn got the watch. No? Lynn's got the Lady Boulevard. Oh, she got instruments. Whoa! How about that? Now she has instruments. Oh, yeah, those come with guts. Those are nice ones, too. They're nice and slender, very feminine. I mean, she's not an ox, you know, she has delicate little fingers, you know. I mean, she needs feminine writing tools.
Why not?
Okay, it's Mark.
Who's?
Mark. No, it's a cat.
No,
it's
five. Right, it's 10 women this time.
You know what they'll say, you want them, you go get them.
Oh, he picks the little teeny one. That's the gold. He really isn't a gold watch, Mark. I mean, if you're looking for a gold watch, please look further. Oh, that's 12, but I really wanted a Longines. What is it? Cufflink?
Keyhole.
Oh yes, Mark got his promotion to, what is it? Executive chef, and he got his keys to the building. Now he has a gold key holder. Is it? Oh, look, gold from here. The light reflected on it and gave it, oh, it is silver colored.
Hey.
Is that a key back? Ace, is that a key back?
I got a ham there.
Does it pull? Oh, does it unhook? One side must unhook. Good, then you can put the company keys on one ring and your girlfriend's keys on the
okay,
other.
There you go. You got a lot of keys there. Might
this is going to be a tough decision.
Well, he's a real stud. You always have a whole pocket full of keys that you don't know what they ever fit. What?
Stay over there.
And here she is. Got her contacts on so her glasses don't reflect. She's gonna give you a little smile in a minute. There, you almost had a smile, Carl. Hope springs eternal. Maybe she'll give you one yet. Come on, you gotta give Uncle a smile now. He's been waiting for a year. There you go. Boy, that sure wasn't worth the wait. Oh, a dollhouse. Oh, sheets and pillowcases.
Mom,
oh,
you
wow.
What is it?
Ramp. She likes the Kimpak better. Wrapping papers. Good, she needs that. There's sheets and pillowcases. Good, Kathy likes the Kimpak. I'll tell you what, now, when my birthday comes, I want it wrapped with a bow. They're all gone. He grabbed it first time around. He knew what it was. Look at that. Now you watch this. Watch out of that whole box. Watch what he grabs first. No, you watch. And he's gonna say just what I wanted. No, that came with the hole in it already. See how gently he opens the package? Look how gently he opens that package. Look at that. The rest of these animals rip it like gorillas, and he so gently undoes all the tape. So sweet and kind. I thought I just put scotch tape over that. How did that get like? Oh, I did that at work because it kept popping open. Either that or he's opening the wrong side. Socks if he's a balloon, maybe. See, it's more fun when they have to work at opening the box. See, look at up something. That makes it light. Watch. He's gonna look at the rubber. Look at that. See, he got some rubber packing. See that? Look, one for each side of your head. That's packing material. That's your mouth.
Make your own speakers.
See? He got a flashlight and some tools, and now he can go unscrew in the dark. Yeah, now he can go screw around in the dark.
Mother and child.
That's what our circuit boards come back to.
Yeah.
In
heart, so tender.
Where were you? Where were you?
I was in Florida.
Sleep.
Uh-oh. In Betty got oranges from Florida. See, oh, thank you. Oh, thank you. I like round orange things. Or pink or whatever.
Sorry to me.
Like this. Oh, and they got belly buttons too. Ooh, Navel. I like round things with belly buttons. Look, see? They don't grow these in California. They got those little teeny weeny juice oranges. Down in Florida, they got real oranges.
Hey, California, we don't want any of that fly.
Oh, no, they got that fly doo-doo all over it.
Where's me? Dog, don't like that.
They do have Ernie and Julio out there, though. It can't be all bad.
No.
You know that even with that little star over the bulb, it's terribly bright. I'm sure I'm going to be very pale and washed out. I'm going to look like Mr. Whitey.
Huh?
Well, I don't know. Move your arms like this and we'll see. Show off your outfit. Show Karl your bra that you bought that is just you. No?
No.
Why? No? But he's waiting. I mean, he's 1,500 miles away, laughing at all of the frivolity and stupidity that is being that is being exhibited here this evening.
Actually, it's 4 a.m, Karl. We're just making you think that it's nighttime.
And he said Johnny was afraid to get in front of the camera.
Yeah. If Joni's afraid to get in front of the camera, let her look at this bunch. Yeah,
the old clock on a wall says 8:45, and that's a.m., not p.m.
That's right.
All night we've been doing this stupid stuff.
It's fun.
And you can't see it here, but behind Irma there's that dish full of that white powder with the little spoon that's kept us going night after night. Yeah.
powdered sugar.
Oh, that powdered sugar.
Does everybody want to say farewell to now so Joe's back?
Oh, yeah. Aloha. No, we won't sing. No, Joni is going to divorce him right away. if he doesn't let her... If he doesn't let Joni see this, I don't blame him in the least. I wouldn't want anybody to know this was related to me. Okay.
Happy birthday
to you. When is his birthday? Is he a Saggy?
No.
Scorpio. Oh, his birthday is in June.
Very good, Theodore. Alvin, you're a little flat. Watch it.
When is his birthday? July? Oh, well, that figures. Yeah. Okay. Did anybody? Should we tell Karl that he's not allowed in here with his designer jeans? This is a high class establishment. No jeans. They didn't want to let him in a restaurant because he had his.
In this next segment. You must understand, it was a long, hard winter, and everybody's not fully recovered from the effects of cabin fever. Under doctor's orders, we all have to spend as much time as possible outdoors. But, as you'll be able to tell after watching this segment, it really isn't helping all that much.
Hello, Karl. Here we are again. This is 6 months later. As you can see, you haven't got your Christmas present yet, but we have decided to give you a view of Matthew's graduation party and combine the two of them, and perhaps you may get this by Christmas of 82. 83, as Aunt Betty says. So here we are all. We're going to have a pan view of everybody. Pan camera. That's good. Everybody look at the camera. You're on.
Which camera are they on?
You're on. Everybody wave and say hello. Pass it over to Aunt.
Here, Kathy, say hello.
Hello?
Oh, no. We're going down here.
Hello and goodbye.
Oh, gosh. Uh-oh. Well, in case Carl sees us, hi, wish you were here, that's for sure. Yeah, right, he hasn't seen the Christmas ones yet, right? Right.
Bonnie, you want to say hello?
I've never met you, Carl, but I've been in L.A. You can have it.
Okay.
So is the mic on? Yeah, it's on.
Is this mic on right now?
Yeah.
Hello, Carl. How are you? We are at Matthew's graduation here. This is pretty good. If you'll step over here, young man, we'll come over here and interview some of these here people that are. Oh yes. Yes. Now, right now, we're going to give this microphone to Matthew, and he can introduce his friends. Carl. Well, no. By the time. He's coming out pretty soon now.
All right, hello, yeah, I'm here. Everybody's here. These are all my friends, Dad. No, all right. Hi, guys. Next.
Hello.
This is PewDiePie right here is Allison.
I got the name right.
Yes, I finally got the name right on this one.
Matt, when you hear this voice next time you see the film, you'll know who it is.
Hi. High school.
What is your name, young man?
Sherrod.
Sherrod? You're talking into a mic and you're being filmed by video over there. See the camera?
Hi. Shut up, you guys.
Oh, my God.
Okay, Dave. Let's have one of those. Well, anything you want, just look in the camera.
I'm speechless. 4 stars, 7 years ago. I'll give it to Debbie.
Okay.
No, here's Debbie. Debbie is my girlfriend. Am I getting too close to the mic? Tell me. I've already had one cup of sangria. After I kicked it off the third day. Alright, yeah. Yeah, I did fairly well at graduation. I received a Belfour Award, and it was totally unexpected. And and also, I did well in track this year. I went to the state meet and placed fourth, and that's about it.
I'll grab it. Now, next, we're going to say hello to... my nephew, Paul. Okay. You want to say something, Paul?
No.
Oh, okay. He says nothing. Now, next we'll go to Kyle. Kyle is, as you know, you introduce him, Michael.
It's a pleasure. I'd just like to say a few things. I'd just like to say a few thousand words.
Kyle, why don't you say hi?
Well, I guess on to other bigger and better things.
Here you go, Kyle. All right. I'm the commentator here, Carl, and I thank you. Now we'll go to this here next young gentleman over here. He's going to say 1,000 words, and I'm pretty sure that he's got his tongue in cheek, okay?
What are you saying, young man?
Nothing? Okay, thank you. Now this young lady over here is a... say something, my dear.
Something, my dear.
Okay, very good. There you go. Now, how do you like that?
We've had our turns. Thank you, kind of. Mr. Reporter, thank you very much, but we've been waited on already.
You have?
Or whatever.
Yep. Have you?
Yes.
Yep.
All these young ladies here, my God.
Have you?
The old clock on the wall says time to cut it off.
Oh, the old clock on the wall says time to cut it off? Sorry, Carl. We all love you, and I hope to live in Dale. I wish you were here, really, because we miss you, and Aunt Betty will be out in a few minutes. And I don't know what to say now. David, what are you doing? I wish, well, we'll go back to this here young man right here. He seems to be a little bit impromptu on his, hey, you know, this is my grandson, my youngest grandson, aren't you?
Yeah, you're a good-looking guy, aren't you? Yeah.
Can he hear me when I'm talking away from the phone? The phone. Are you taking my picture now? Oh, well, yeah, okay. Now, this is...
Right now, we're talking to Mr. Sandner. Okay. Mr. Sandner, please say a word to our viewing public.
Please say a word to our viewing public. Okay. Mr. Zidane here ran track with Matthew, and so...
No, I never ran track.
Oh, no.
I'm his physics partner.
No, he's his physics partner. Pardon me.
Yeah, I didn't
know. Oh, very good.
I'm the guy who catches the javelins.
Hey. The arrows in the air. Does somebody else want to... Uncle John, come in the picture. Is Aunt Betty coming out here? Well, Carl, I hope you're patient with me because I'm speechless here just a little bit. These young ladies over here, let me go back over here again and cut through the... yes. Debbie, why don't you say something?
Something.
Just something.
So Uncle Karl can get his view.
Everybody's going to say something, right? Something.
Isn't she pretty, Karl? And you can write us a letter and give me your viewpoint. And I'm pretty sure that you're going to concur with me. And now, Allison, I told you before, she's the young lady over there also. I didn't mean to point. But I think it's a very nice crowd here, don't you think? A little crowded, but it's all right. Now, Matthew, what do you want to say?
Nothing.
Am I saying too much?
I don't know.
Knock it off!
Busy, knock it off, Carl. Unaccustomed or what?
I said, unaccustomed as I am to public speaking.
Yes.
What would you like me to say?
Oh, well, anything your heart desires.
Well, I'd just like to wish...
Come step over here just a little bit. Okay.
Yes, sir. I just want to add my congratulations to the graduate on his accomplishment and all the graduates here and how honored I am to be among your presence and where are they.
Your
presents. Oh, yeah, well, your presents are in the house, too.
Half a minute.
Mm-hmm. Yes. What else are you going to say, Betty? Aunt Betty?
What?
Aunt Betty.
You going to go do the dishes for me, Ray, or
no.
You want me to finish them?
No,
all right.
You got to.
You know, I'm getting an extra $2.50 an hour for cleaning up after this party. Hope you realize that.
That is all we're going to talk about. Hey, Mary! Mary, where are you? Mary, I know that. What's your name, young lady? Huh? Now, you already know this young lady, Carl, and I'm sure that...
I do.
I'm sure that we both love her very much, but I'm sorry to say that, yes.
What are you talking about?
That's my cake. And the next young lady, I want you to look
he
at.
He knows Mary.
Does he?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh,
he
you.
At his house.
Oh, do you know Mary? Oh, you lucky dog, you. How does this say? Well, let's go take a look at her again, okay? So, Mary Joswick, okay? Okay. Now, as we both know here, I'm the luckiest because I'm sitting next to her here. See? Well. And beautiful, isn't she? So, Mary, would you like to say something to Carl? Maybe thank him?
Carl who?
Well, I'm sorry you couldn't be here, and Lynn and I'd love another trip to California, right?
There, go ahead.
Just money.
Just money.
Just send money, yes.
No, go ahead.
Huh?
And I don't know, I guess that's it.
How come you're so pretty?
Oh, Ring.
Huh? Hey, going. Is he? How about that, Carl?
I'm camera shy.
Isn't that nice? Oh, you can't be camera shy. Not at this early age.
Who's the cameraman?
Who's the camera? Mm-hmm. What's your name?
Yeah. Yeah?
That's David Arnold.
Oh, okay. Hi, David.
That's Carl's nephew.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know
it's
that?
Been a long time, yeah.
Been a long time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And Carl, I think you're pretty lucky, really. And how come you're not smiling?
I don't know.
I can say once the whole time.
Mr. Microphone.
Mr. Microphone.
This is a microphone you should be talking into. Right here.
Wait, I gotta get the right the length for it. This is how you get the tune. That's the 1, 2, 3.
That's how you do it?
Yeah.
Your picture's been taken.
Oh, my God.
What? Uh-oh. College. Am I supposed to hold this or what? Oh, man.
Can you hear the tearing of the paper, Carl?
Tear, tear, tear.
Well, in the meantime, do you want to say something, young man? No, I guess not.
Hey, how do I open this thing?
Hey, you take this. Hey, look at that, eh? Here, say something.
Is it what thing?
Oh, yeah.
Turn that around. Show them. Turn it around.
This last segment is called God's Country, even though... Okay. This last segment is called God's Country, even though it seems to me this is the country God forgot. Of course, some people prefer it as a lifestyle, as does Sam Hunstorfer, but he only appears briefly in this segment. I think maybe he was a little camera shy, because every time we took our cameras around, he was nowhere to be found. So, here's God's Country.
Down Patterson Road. We approach Sand Hill. Come on, approach. In the driver's seat, we have the one and only Miss Kathy Fox. And behind the camera, we have Mr. David Arnold. We take a left at Sand Hill Road, approaching the early American logging camp. Michigan, upper lower Michigan, I should say.
Okay.
What?
Just give me directions.
Just look at the green and the purple and the yellow and the green. Off to our right, we have a nice valley. There's no deer out at this time of the day. Yes.
much to say about the woods, but I'm trying my best. We have a branch we're going to hit? Okay.
The cameraman falls off the thing. He just branches and drives.
We have a... Perkins, Northern Michigan Safari here. Off to the right, between trees, you can see Aunt Irma's trailer. Off to the left, there's a dead tree.
Wanna go by the trailer?
Oh, from where? Oh. Off to the left, between the trees, we see Aunt Irma and Uncle John's trailer. Oh, yeah. To the right.
Oh, God.
Lose all track of direction. We may get a closer view of later. And onward. Forward.
Sorry.
Why am I going backwards? Because you're on a hill. More gas. Okay. I don't know if the camera's on, but there's not really much to say about the roads. Just to let you get some breathtaking view. This part up here. And halt. Hey, here we are at the logging camp. It's a lovely breeze out. Nice moth over here. No, there's no rain. It looks like rain. It's very deceiving. Now we shall dig for Uncle Bud's railroad track, which Dave's stepping on the cord. Oh, we have to let Uncle Karl meet Kathy. He hasn't met Kathy yet. Step into the limelight here.
No, thank you.
We discovered in California. Say a word.
Hello.
Where did you guys say driver training?
Say something to
Diesel
Uncle Karl.
School?
I just learned how to drive one of these things.
This is Kathy Fox, my friend and co-worker.
That's what's wrong. Hello. You have a mirror up.
We're digging.
Terrific.
You say a word.
A word.
Oh, you guys are great with that one. That one has gone. I think it's been
that's
overused.
That's in every party there is.
Hey,
this is longer. It's more
overused.
It's more down here. Here we have an ancient squirt can. And some other goodies. Got some beer cans. This funny looking piece of machinery. Just dug this up. It's an ancient computer.
It goes on forever.
I told you I thought it was a railroad track because it was so big.
Yeah.
Person's eye view of the logging camp. Standing from the middle, if somebody was spinning around, this is what they would see. We have some lovely tree stumps. And some pretty purple flowers.
That's Russian thistle.
What did we find last time?
The horseshoes.
Oh, last time we dug here, we found some horseshoes. An old shoe. Plenty of tin cans.
And plenty of spikes.
Yes, tons of railroad spikes.
A lot of broken bottles.
Broken
We're
bottles.
We're trying to make our fortune in bottles.
Old bottles. We have camera-shy people here. Let's see, what else do we have? There's not much to say about the logging camp.
There's not much left.
We're on our way to Uncle Bud's cabin. Just after this nice thunderstorm we just had, there's a few puddles you may see. Okay. Kathy's driving again. Just trying. Here's Uncle Bud's new picket fence. With the standard no trespassing sign on the front. It's a nice puddle we're going to go through. Stop or not. Okay, we're in Uncle Bud's neck of the woods here. There's a nice little path off to your right. This fallen tree to your left. And the long and winding road is straight ahead. Cameraman requested the long way around. Living complex. the bugs came in. There's a abandoned car, storage truck. Here's the ever-famous well. Is there something on the ground I should see? This is the front door. Oh, we're going around now. This is a knotted log. A window. Antennas. Lots of antennas up there. I'm gonna see them. This is the new addition, the latest thing in cabins, the bathroom, indoors. The starting of a winter wood pile here. And what else would have got up there? The steam engine and the back, the front entrance. Okay. It's the frog pool, it's bird pond, whatever. Oh, this is a shed with wood in it. What else do you want to see? We got them. Screens in this shed. Could be interesting. Here, a garbage pile. Nice garbage pile. Oh, let's go inside the cabin. Go. Now I'm standing in the center of Uncle Bat. I'm standing in the middle of Uncle Bud's cabin now. And, you want me to show? Oh, point. Okay, here's a bed. Oh, start on this side. This is the kitchen area. The refrigerator? Huh? Inside we have, yes, keg beer on tap. Keeps it cold. We have a sink, stove, all the comforts of the city. We have the laundromat up here. Huh? We got some shoes. We have the heater here. We have storage. That's about it. Bed. Nice. I forgot. And what else do we have? That's about it. I'll meet him on the other side to show you the back, the bathroom. Oh, you want me to stay in here and invite you in? Hi, come on in and see the bathtub.
Showing us the nice hot water heater.
It's a hot water heater and some other good-looking things. Huh? Interesting. Here's the other side view of Uncle Bud's cabin. We're going to go show you your property now. Check out how it's doing. It's still there. Thank you.
night.
Okay, you record?
Not until she starts talking.
But you gotta say something. You can hear yourself. You always sound different over videotape.
Your head out of
this story, we hope you enjoyed. On behalf of my relatives and myself, we all wish you good health, good happiness, and good night.